Rajdeep from BR Softtech Private Limited. We established in 2010 and we have a global presence with over 500 plus team members. We are a CMMI Level 3 certified firm and have delivered over 8,000 plus projects so far. Our development team is skilled in all the prominent and latest technologies. Today we will go through a quick overview of BR Grocery and Delivery Solution. This is based on Swiggy model and the product is available with just food delivery mode as well.
We have three user modes in BR Grocery and Food Delivery Solution: customer, vendor and driver. Your vendors are restaurants as well as superstores, supermarkets. For customer and driver, there are mobile application. For vendor, there is mobile application and web view as well. We will start with the customer application first. Once you are logged in, this is the home screen for the customer. At the top, the GPS location is displayed. You have the option for offers. Four major service categories are listed here: food delivery, grocery and essentials, party bookings, railway booking. You have the offer banners just below it. Then you have the top picks for you. All the nearby restaurants and food stores are listed here. Below it, you have the option for discount offers. At the bottom of the screen, you have the option to search for any particular restaurant or food or grocery store. You have the option to view your cart and the account page. At the top, you can manage your contact details and your login credentials. Then you have the option to manage your addresses in account, your payments, your favorites, your offers, help and support, and then you have the listing of your past orders and logout. We will start with the food delivery first. Once you choose food delivery, you can view the list of nearby restaurants. You can view the name and the address of the restaurant, the ratings, the minimum delivery time, the prices for two on average. Then you have the recommended product list here. You have the option for menu to browse through the food menus. You can choose any one item, view their price, add the quantity in your cart. Once the items are added in your cart, you can go to view cart. You can get an overview of the order here. If you want to give any particular instruction to the restaurant, you can enter those here. You can apply for discount. You can view your pricing breakdown. You can view how much you are saving on this. Then you have the option to select address or add a new address. In select address, your saved addresses will be listed here. You can choose that and proceed to pay. Your payment options will be listed here. Choose anyone and your order is placed successfully. This is the order tracking screen for the customer. It gives the location overview between the customer location and the restaurant, and the order status are displayed here. Now we will switch to the restaurant mode and process this order. This is the dashboard page for the restaurant panel. They can view an overview from here. Their sales for the day are listed here, total earnings, the recent orders, like this. On the left hand side, there are options for the orders, your dashboard, your status to go online or offline, to manage your profile, your earnings, your product types. In product types, you can manage the product listing here, add new items, or deactivate anyone. Then you have product management. In this, you add the items with the prices and the discount and the cooking time, all these kind of details. Along with the categories, you have the option to edit these or delete anyone, or you can add a new one. Then you have coupon management. restaurants are able to provide their own coupons to their customers. Then we have discount management. Now we will move to the order page. So your orders are listed here. There are four tabs in this: new order, preparing order, ready order, and past orders. The newest orders are listed at the top. Vendors can view the phone number of the customer, the total price, order ID, order number, when it was created, pending, and they can view the item details from here, what is to be prepared. Once the order is overviewed by the restaurant, they can change the status to preparing. Now this order has been shifted to preparing tab. Once the order is prepared and ready for the pickup from the driver, the vendors can update the status as prepared. Now this order is moved to the ready tab. It is now available in the prepared and ready section. Same is being displayed in the customer application that the food is being prepared. Now we will switch to the delivery application. Once you are logged into the application, this is the first screen for the driver. From this, they can start the duty for the day. This is their dashboard. On the left hand menu, we have given the option to go online or offline for this status. They are earning floating cash, that's the cash they have received from the customers directly that they will need to settle with the admin. Live task, the tasks they are on right now. New task, login history, refer a friend, help, legal and logout. Your new orders are available here. Drivers can view a quick overview of the restaurant location and the delivery location and the bill details. They have the option to accept this order. Once accepted, it goes to your live task. In live task, the first task for the driver is to reach the pickup location. At the top, they can view the address and they have the option to redirect to Google Map for navigation as well. Once the driver has reached to the restaurant location, they can choose the status as reached pickup location. From this, now the same has been updated in the customer application as well, that the driver has reached at the restaurant and waiting for to pick up your order. Now let's go back to the driver application. Once the driver has picked up all the items in the menu, they can confirm that the items have been picked up and update the status as pickup complete. At this time, they can provide a rating to the restaurant as well. Once submitted, now their task is to reach the customer's location. Now all these notification, all this status are updated in the customer app as well. Now it shows that your order has been picked up and out for delivery. Again, the driver has the option to use Google Map for the navigation. Once the driver reaches the customer's location, they can choose this option. The price, the amount which is to be collected from the customer in case of cash booking is displayed here. They can choose as collect now. They can enter the amount given by the customer, confirm the amount, update as cash collected, and choose the final status as delivery complete and confirm. At this time, they can review the delivery experience as well. Once delivered, the order is completed from the driver. If we go back to the customer application now, we have the option to confirm that I have received this or not delivered. Once done, okay, I got it. I can go to my account section and the newest order is listed here. I can view the overview when it was delivered, the price breakdown and everything, and the option to reorder as well. going back to the home screen, in grocery and essential category, it works the same. Your location is listed at the top. You can search for any particular store or item, and your stores are listed here. You can browse for any one particular according to your location. You can open it up. You can view their inventory, the rating, and the time frame, etc. You can view the item details from here and add these in your cart. The order process is same as the food delivery items. We can go through a quick overview of the grocery. This is the dashboard for the grocery store. They can also view a timeline of their orders. On the left hand menu, they have the option to go online, offline. View is same for the grocery vendor and food vendors. They can view the latest order at the top. They can view the item details, view the prices and everything. They can again update the status as preparing. Once the order is prepared, they can update the status as prepared, and then it will be picked up for the driver for delivery. Then they have the option to manage their profile, their earning, the product types, product management, coupons and discounts. Now we will switch to the admin side. This is the dashboard for the admin. They can view at the top the requested restaurants and driver. Any new vendor or driver who wants to join with the admin, their request will be listed here. They can view the sales and earning for the day, recent orders, recent food orders and restaurant order are segregated here. Driver request, the earning for the day, all of this. On the left hand menu, we have given the option to manage the profile, manage the earnings. In the earning, they can view the earning for the restaurants and grocery separately. And we have the vendor management. In this, there is the option for restaurant vendor, grocery vendor, railway parcel vendor, and parcel party booking vendor as well. Then we have order management. In order management, vendor can view the restaurant order. In this, the overall order for all the restaurants will be listed here. We have restaurant cancel order. So all the orders which are cancelled by the restaurant for any reason will be displayed here so that admin can go through those. We have item wise restaurant order report, grocery order, grocery cancelled order, item wise grocery report and discounts. Then we have the option for driver management. The drivers for restaurant and grocery are different, though their application is same. Admin can view the drivers for any particular restaurant. They can generate a report for their earnings. The same can be done for the grocery driver as well. And we have the user management. This is your customer management. List of the customers, their order, their amount and everything. And we have the option to manage the cuisine type and grocery category type. We have vendor outlet management. Admin can manage the restaurant's offices and grocery offices. We have floating cash management. This is all the cash received by the drivers which need to be settled with the grocery and the restaurant store. Then we have restaurant fare management. This is the delivery charges and the commission management. Then we have grocery fare management. This is again the same part, delivery charges and admin commission. Driver earning management. We have the payment history for the admin. They can review the restaurant payment history, driver payment history, grocery payment history, grocery driver payment history. They have location management to manage the country, state, city, region, etc. Then we have reviews management. Admin is able to go through all the reviews posted by the customer for restaurants and grocery stores separately. They have CMS pages management and one-page report for the complete overview.
Thank you for watching. For your queries and demos, please contact me.